normally when I'm standing for such a big crowd, I'm playing the trumpet or spinning some records behind the DJ booth. I'm actually not used to talk in front of such a big crowd, especially not in English, so please don't mind if I'm looking for the right words. First, so question. Who has noticed the moving box in this room? Please, it's one, two, so not very much. Well, it's over here. So the next question, who is curious about what's inside of this box? Okay, that's nice, that's nice. Well, I'm going to talk you through this half hour. So I'm Paul Kooi, BI consultant at Zig Websoftware, in Dutch Zig, but you may call it Zig Websoftware. And I'm doing this case for Woon Friesland. It's a housing association in the north of the Netherlands. Well, I'm going to talk you through these points, the process, what did happen, the bottlenecks, the adjustments, and also the results. So let's see, what is the process we're talking about today? Well, for the housing associations, it's so when someone is moving out a house, they're going to talk this to the housing association, and they say, yeah, I want to move out. And then the housing association has to find another person to live in the in this property. But if this process is taking too long, well, the house will be empty and there is no income at all. Well, knowing this, well, we at Zig Websoftware, we know when the process started and when it's when it ended. But actually, we didn't know what was what's really doing this. What's really the process? So, for us, it was like, so it's already here. For us, it was like a black box. We actually don't know, but it's there. But we actually don't know what's doing. So we were curious, so we asked to Woon Friesland. We went there, we had a cup of coffee or tea, and also a nice snelle jelle for the Dutch. Kruidkoek, or in English, gingerbread. Well, that says Google Translate. So let's see. First of all, I'm going to tell you something about the real process. So we already know, when someone wants to move out, he has 30 days to actually move out and then find his new place. In the meantime, the housing association published the property online so that the home seekers can find can react on this property. And eventually, when the 7 days are over, it's going offline, and then the property is being offered to the next in line. So the home seeker can now reject or accept the offer, but when it's rejected, it's going back to the housing association, and then it's going and then it's offered to the next in line. And when it's accepted, they eventually get the key. So it's really basic. This is what is happening. So what are the costs of an empty property? Well, on average, we have a property is around 450 euros each month. That means 15 euros a day. And for this case, Woon Friesland, they have around 1,300 properties they have to do every year. So what is happening, and what were the expectations from us, from Woon Friesland, and what did actually happen? Well, we see over here the desirable, this is what's okay. So when you when your process is within 30 days, it's okay. You don't have any cost because after the first one has moved out, you have already a new one moving in. So Woonfriesland thought, well, it's around 35 days to actually accept an offer, and then it's 5 days to sign the contract. But in fact, we see over here, it took up 43 days to accept the offer, and even 54 days to actually sign the contract. So it's almost 24 days more than what's desirable. So when we're talking about money, we see, well, in this case, we had up to 600 cases, and for 24 days, and then 15 euros a day, that means around 216,000 euros per 6 months. So this is the process we're talking about in disco style. And we see over here, this is the publish time, and here the list of candidates. Here's the offering part, rejection and exception. So this is no spaghetti like the where is he? Yeah, like you had. So let's have a closer look at the offering part. So this is happening. The system says, okay, this is the right order of next home seekers. And then the employee has to get the right person, or selects the right person to offer this house. And then he can accept or reject. And when it's rejected, it's going back to the employee, and then he has to select the next one, and if he's rejecting also, the next one, and so on, and so on. Until someone accepts this offer, and then he gets the keys. Okay, what's then the problem, you think? Well, you see over here, it takes 14 hours before the employee puts clicks on the button to actually offer this this property. You think, 14 hours, that's okay. Well, I don't think so. Let's see. What are the delaying elements over here? Well, I already said the system is waiting for the employee to do something. And another problem is that they have to call the new home seekers to actually offer this this property. So it's taking quite a long time. We will see later. And the next bottleneck. So the next bottleneck is over here at the rejection part, where we see it takes 6 days before someone rejects the offer. 6 days is quite a long time, especially when we're looking at other housing associations. We see the maximum time they get is around 3 days. And here, so it's almost a double. This is because of when Woonfriesland offers this this property, they call and they also send an email. And if there is no email address, when they don't know the email address, they have to send the letter. So the letter takes up 3 days to arrive, and then they have also 3 days to let the housing association know if they're accepting or rejecting. And they also has to do this by telephone or at the desk, or well, it's also possible they don't let anything know, so there's no answer. And then the system is waiting and waiting until the 6 days are over. So the last bottleneck over here is the exception part. And when we zoom in, we see 24 days to accept the property. This is taking also quite a long time. Well, the first part is by the home seeker, who has to telephone or go to the desk to say, yes, I want this property. But there's also a problem with the employee, because after the exception is made by the home seeker, Well, then the employee has to check if all criteria are fitting this this property, and if all documents are correct. And well, eventually they have to make an appointment to visit the property, and then check if everything is all right. Well, we made up three changes for WoonFriesland. The first one is the automatic process. Well, you see later on what happened over there. They now can also accept and reject by website, and they get notifications by email when someone accepted the offer. So actually, the process didn't change that much, except for this part. There's no employee involved offering the properties anymore. No, it's all being made by the system. And then also the home seeker can accept or reject, even in weekends, even at night. So that's much faster. And then eventually they get the key. So this is the new sheet, new situation, and we see the old situation, the old route is also possible, so manual by the employee, and also the automatic offer is over here, and accepting by website. So this is the new route. Well, let's have a look at this part, the offer part. So we see now, because of the notifications, the manual part is going going faster by 5 hours. So instead of 14 hours, it's now 9 hours. And the automatic part, it's now being made in 1 hour. So it's 13 hours faster than before. This means that looking at 6 months, we see we had made 600 days faster than it was before. But there's more. Because of this part, we see the accept and reject part by website. We see that instead of being waiting 6 days to reject the property, we see now it's been made in 2.5 days. So that means 3.5 days faster than it was before. We also see, this is actually new, because this part, it wasn't there before. But we see when the home seeker gets an offer and they're happy with this offer and they want to accept it, they do it quite fast, 1 day. And even when it's made by the automatic offer, we see it's almost a half day to accept the offer. And this in this case, we see when only by rejecting, rejecting part is 3.5 days faster, we see we have made 1,150 days faster than before. This means every 6 months we don't have to wait for 1,150 days. So let's see the last one, the accept phase. So it was 24 days to accept the offer, and now it is 17 days. So that's 7 days faster than it was before, and this means every property is being going through the process faster with 7 days. And this is all because of the notifications, because when the offer is accepted, the employees immediately knows, I have to do something with this property. And also they don't have to call anymore, and they don't have to do the offer by manual anymore. So they have more time to concentrate on this part. And this means it's faster by 3,500 days. So the results here, so this was this the old situation, 43 days to accept, 54 days to sign the contract. We see now it's in 36 days to accept That means almost 7 days faster and 47 days to sign the contract. So we're still not here, but it's better than it was before. So what does this mean? Well, now they save every month 67,000 euros because they don't have to wait 7.5 days per property anymore. This means they have a total cost of 150,000 euros still to overcome. So that's why, there it is again. The black box, we already know what's happening, but there is still a black box inside. Because we have a lot of questions because, there's still some work to do here. So what are we gonna do? Well, that's we have to find out new bottlenecks. We have to look at the old bottlenecks and check if they can be much faster than we are already now. And we also gonna do this for other housing associations. But the big question now is what's really inside the black box? And that I want to invite you to come. About 10 minutes to check yourself and take what's inside for yourself, and I hope you think it's delicious. What would that be?
Okay, thanks so much. Again, I'll start with the first question, and you can also raise your hand if you have a question for Paul as well. Now, so I was wondering, of course, you're in a very good position because your company, Zich, makes the software that is used by the housing associations to run their processes. Yeah. So you can make these automations and, let's say, also this analysis for them very well, and you have access to the data. Yeah. So what I was wondering, when you started with this analysis, could you use the data from your system immediately out of the box, or did you have to make some kind of changes, and which one?
Yeah, no, I couldn't use the data right from the database, no. Actually we had a lot of work to do, and I'm doing this in Excel to find the right data to for the process mining tool.
Okay, so improving the logging is also something that's on
That's one of our things to do, on the to-do list, yeah.
Okay, great, thank you. Any questions for Paul?
Okay. I haven't quite understood where the loss is incurred. I mean, you have tenancy periods of 1 month. You have an advance notice period of 1 month, which typically you have to notify you're going to leave the house before you enter the last month in which you rent it. So it would seem there's no point in being faster in finding a new tenant than 1 month. So where exactly does that loss occur?
I hope I understand the question, but I think you're saying the process is within 30 days, then you don't have to do anything anymore. So am I right? Yeah. Okay. Well, that is partly correct because indeed, when it's within 30 days, you don't have extra cost because the house of the property isn't empty, but there's still there's also another part because when it's taking too long, when this process is taking too long, the house seekers they want to know in what position they are and if they're getting this property yes or no. And when they know this faster, that's also a better way to service the home seekers.
Thank you.
Okay.
If I may, hello. I just wanted to ask if during your initial analysis if you checked the employee workload performance, because during our proof of concept we tried to propose it to the company, and because of the situation with the unions and so on, they actually didn't wanted to do it, to find out whether Bob is really faster than Joe and how the team is actually performing. Yeah.
Well, we actually haven't. We didn't actually find out what the workload was at Woon Friesland. But with this process mining tool, we saw okay, the process is faster. They have actually doing the same work, only on a different time. Stamp. So this is, it's just the beginning, and this is where we can check if there are, well, better solutions or better ways to improve the process.
More questions for Paul?
Property accept and reject is about matching a property to a potential seeker. Did Disco help you in drilling down the matching success, so the accept and reject ratios in the different areas?
I'm sorry, I didn't understand.
No? The core business about leasing out the property is finding a new seeker. Mm-hmm. So it's about matching to a new seeker. Did Disco help you in improving the matching process?
No, not yet. But
okay.
We have to look for
next
that.
Step.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Yep.
I'm sorry.
One more question or nobody? Okay, well, then let's enjoy a lunch break. Thanks again. Let's thank again, Paul.